should be out any minute now. I wonder if I'll know her. Why did you leave her when you ran away? Well, I planned to come back for her one day. I wrote her letters. I never got an answer. You know who this is?
I think I do.
I came as soon as I heard.
Everything's all taken care of. He's very fit.
Didn't know you'd be so pretty.
Where have you been all these years?
I wrote to you. Even when I didn't get an answer, I kept on writing.
At least to come by once in a while. Just to see if I was alive or dead.
I did that too. I stood over in those woods watching you and watching him. I was trying to get up enough courage to walk up to you and take you away. I was scared of him, Lois May.
I know.
I haven't been much of a mother to you up until now. I'd like to start trying.
Don't you think it's a little late?
May I say something? Lois May. Mary Ellen. And I was your mother. I'd grieve for the time we'd lost. But I'd hope that we could make it up in the years to come. Lois May, could we just go for a walk together and talk about it?
I can only ask you to take my word for the end of the story of Lois May Bascom, for truth is far stranger than fiction. I was to meet her many years later, when she had become not a scientist, but the wife of a diplomat. She now lives abroad, and I expect that sometimes her memories, as mine do, return to those Depression years and Walton's Mountains.